I'm Philip Abadicio. Join me explore the world of arts and artists, the way they live and what they collect. This is the house of Benji Reyes, a furniture designer. Come with me. Wonderful place. It's full of wood. So, how do you source your wood?
Now, these are all reclaimed wood from old houses.
Ah, okay.
So, I only use reclaimed wood for all my projects.
So, most of these are Molave, Kamagong?
Well, Molave, Kamagong, Dungon, Balayong, Supa, a lot of varieties. I built the house 21 years ago. It's a work in progress.
Always.
Ends. It never ends, yeah.
It looks like it. But it's also nice because it seems like you took pieces from older houses and put it all together.
Yeah.
Your floors are also.
These are all old houses. This is Saplungan. It's a cousin to Yakal. It's very, very dense wood.
Yeah, we don't even hear about those wood anymore.
Yeah. You just see them in old houses. The trusses of the house, the bottom cord, came from an old bridge.
Benji Reyes is an innovative furniture maker who uses traditional woodworking techniques to create compelling, sinuous silhouettes. Going beyond craft, he's best known for turning salvaged wood into functional art.
Yeah, the design, I wanted water around the house. No gutter so I can collect the rainwater. So during summer, it cools down the house. Sort of like the radiator of the house, cools it down. And then the overflow from the pond goes to the garden. So everything passes through the filtration system and then pumped back to the pond. And then to fill it
up. Wastewater is used for the plants.
For the plants. That's why everything's so lush.
Wow, it's so beautiful. I mean, you can really be so creative.
But, that's the entire idea, to create a space where you can concentrate and.
So you're in your wobble and everything's safe.
Yes.
And Mother Nature loves.
These are some of my sculptures. Balabal, Bailarina, and then Fishda. I have the love for wood and the knack for building things. And then what helped me a lot was my background in architecture and finally putting things together. Number one, it has to be functional. So you have the cabinet at the bottom. And then you have your drawers. But it doesn't stop there. I call it functional sculpture. So sculptural in a way that you create something that attracts people to it. When I was a lot younger, I would say, I'm gonna make this out of this wood, sculpt it out of it. But now the process has changed. Maybe I've matured. I respect the wood, so I also listen to the wood where it wants to take me. So the lines, they're probably a collaboration between nature and my thoughts. So it's combining different species of wood into one piece because each species has its own characteristics.
Benji Reyes won the 1994 Katha Award for the most outstanding design for his Kaha Binet, a chest of drawers with embedded handles, and the Hapag Larawan console.
This one is called the Butlig. It's a chest of drawers.
What is it made of?
It's Molade. Each bump, I sculpted it by hand.
Originally, it was flat.
Flat.
And then you had to.
So it starts off this thick. And then I inlay the handle, it's Kamagong. And then sculpt it ergonomically, correct. And then I sculpt the bumps. A lot of work. So the stairs alone, I consider it as a.
Solid also.
If you look at the side, it's sculptural.
Yes.
So the stringer. I attached the kamagong as the risers. And then this came from an old stringer of an old house, the steps. And then the rails, it's all Molave. So this is another main door, if I may. So that's how you lock it.
And it's actually working. It's not just a decoration. It's actually locked.
You can actually lock it.
Shutters.
Yeah. you can teach anybody woodworking, but the principles behind it, the ideas and the way of life, it has to follow on. The only thing you can teach them is the craft. What's difficult in all the arts, I think, is teaching the eye and the hand coordination.
If somebody would, you know, pursue you and would want to enroll himself,
if you're into it for the money, I think that's wrong. You have to love it. You know? You have to put your heart and soul into it, and everything will just come, eh? Yes, you'll never work your entire life, right?
So not only do you make furniture, you also make accessories.
Accessories, sculptures.
What is it supposed to be?
Oh, I take this with me when I give lectures. It's a different species of wood, so you can feel the weight. And I explain where it's used for. Normally, when you build houses, what's it, the species of wood where it's used for?
What is this?
This one is kamagong.
This one?
This one is daot. So this is by Emong, Elmer Borlongan, his mentor, Sena. And then this one is by Ben Tab. And then you have Gus Albor, Olaso, and Iga.
Everything here is art.
But you want to be surrounded by that. I've been stocking up on wood for the past 30 years. So I still come across new species that I can't even identify. But the way I work with wood is I sculpt on it first. Then I learn the qualities and the characteristics of the species. And then I start using it for free.
How do you want to be remembered? Like what would you want your legacy to be?
That's a good question. My works. The passion and the commitment put into every piece. For people to understand that it's not just the value of aesthetics. It's building it once and building it right. And understanding what people really need as a designer. It's learning from your clients. I want them to understand that the clean wood is better than also to save our environment.
Thanks for joining me. Wasn't that tour rewarding? Well, we'd like you to see artists and designers' homes and how they live. Style is individual, and so let's explore this together. Please leave a comment and we'll get back to you. You can also give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for joining us today, and until the next time, avec plaisir, Philip Lifestyle Guide.